Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Matt, and today we're going to be doing a tier list video for the main series Sonic games. As you can see, we've got them all listed down here. Not going to be focusing on the spinoffs as of right now, just because there's so many of them, and throwing them in this list I just feel like would make the whole thing convoluted and just kind of make the whole thing way more complicated. I may come back and include them or just do a separate one for them entirely. But as of right now, we're just going to be doing the main series Sonic games. As most of you know, I'm a huge Sonic fan. I have tons of experience with these games. That being said, this is all opinion, you know, not, I mean, that should be a given. I just love making tier lists. I've been doing them on Twitter for a while now. And after watching the iDubbbz videos on his tier list, I just kind of want to throw my hat in the ring and start doing these. I feel like including a video would definitely clear the air rather than, you know, trying to sit there and explain it over Twitter. With that being said, let's go ahead and dive in. And I'm just going to be doing these not in chronological order, just kind of in whatever order they're listed in down here. Getting started, we're going to go ahead and focus on Sonic 4 Episode 1. I personally enjoy this game. I know a lot of people had a lot of complaints at this game, and for good reason. There's, you know, it's a buggy nightmare. It's short. There wasn't really a lot of content. And the fact that it gets the Sonic 4 title just kind of seemed disrespectful. Nonetheless, I personally enjoy this game. It's a guilty pleasure of mine, but realistically, I know it's not very, it doesn't really hold up well, and it's not even acknowledged mainly by Sega as a actual like classic Sonic game, as we saw in the Mania trailer. It just kind of got shoehorned out of the elevator scene. So for that reason, I'm going to go ahead and put it in D tier. You know, it's not the worst Sonic game, main Sonic game, I should say, but it's definitely a far cry from the best. So moving on, we got Sonic CD here for the Sega CD. My first experience with it was when it released on the Sonic Gems collection on GameCube. I thought it was a pretty fun game. You know, it like I had no idea what I was doing. I always got the bad future ending because, you know, I was a kid. I wasn't really into getting the time stones and going back and making a good future. I had a way more experience, like I had a way better experience with the game when it released through the Xbox Live Arcade back in like 2011. It also, that included the Japanese soundtrack, which, you know, that honestly, a lot of people says makes the game. So I'm going to have to take Sonic CD, put it in B tier. As far as the Sonic game goes, you know, it's good. It like the level structure is more about exploring than just kind of momentum. So a lot of people prefer that. It's not really my cup of tea when it comes to Sonic games, but the soundtrack is godlike. Good game nonetheless, definitely worth a playthrough. Now we're going to go ahead with Sonic 4 Episode 2. So the Sonic 4 game, it released in episodes. It was Episode 1, Episode 2, and then there was an Episode 3 planned, but it was canceled. Honestly, Episode 2 definitely improved on everything that was wrong with Episode 1. They added Tails. They had, you know, four more zones. It's a better game than four Episode 1, but it's still not great. It's okay. Honestly, I mean, I enjoyed it again, but honestly, it's definitely not worth being anything higher than C. Only reason it's in C, it's higher than Episode 1. It's a better game, but I would say low T or low C, high D. I'm going to give it C just so it's more different than Episode 1. Then we got Sonic Colors here for the Wii. Back in 2009, 2010, I believe. I mean, you know, it introduced the boost. It has a great soundtrack. Pretty fun multiplayer modes. I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in B as well. I don't know if I just missed the hype on it. It didn't really resonate with me as much as like other people. A lot of people say that this is like one of the best Sonic games. I mean, I can agree, but it's not one of mine. I guess I just didn't really enjoy it as much as other people. Slight intermission. I'm really thirsty. I need to go get a bottle of water. Much better. All right, next we've got Sonic Lost Worlds for the Wii U, later for the PC, but for now I'm just going to go ahead and focus on its first main release on the Wii U. Very polarizing game. It's very similar to Mario Galaxy in the sense of like exploration, and they definitely toned down on the speed. It just overall felt like a weird game. So, for that reason, I mean, the soundtrack's great, but honestly, soundtracks can't really carry a game, in my opinion. They're great, but honestly, D-tier game for me, just because, you know, I didn't really get as much enjoyment out of it as I thought I would. Really could have expected better from it. All right, we got Sonic 3 next. One of the classic Sonic games. Very fun game. You know, just front to back, a very great experience. If you're looking, it, honestly, a lot of people will say it is the best classic Sonic game, and I can agree. It's not my personal favorite classic Sonic game, but it's definitely up there. We're going to go ahead and take Sonic 3 and Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I can assume that this little icon here is Sonic and Knuckles. I don't know why it's in the list twice. I didn't put these pictures on here. But we're going to go ahead and group Sonic 3 and Sonic 3 and Knuckles together just because they are, you know, a package, basically. I'm going to go ahead and put them in S tier just because they're fantastic front to back. The Sonic and Knuckles adapter was way ahead of its time in sense of, like, added on content for the games. Just the fact that you could put, like, Sonic 2 in there and play as Knuckles in there, that was just mind-blowing back in the day. Just in the game, the soundtrack is phenomenal. The Michael Jackson inspiration is definitely there. Makes for some of the best Sonic songs in the entire series, in my opinion. So we're gonna go ahead and put both of those in S tier, just because, you know, that's where they deserve to be. They are fantastic games. There's really not much else I can say. And yeah, there's Sonic 3 and Knuckles. All right, next we got Sonic Forces, and I really can't say anything good about this game. It really, really tried. That's pretty much as far as that goes. It definitely tried. In terms of succeeding, not so much. They really did some big strides in the sense of, you know, being able to make your own character and make that character canon. Being able to play as that character alongside some of the main series Sonic characters. So that was really exciting. You know, I bet a lot of people were excited by that. It was a great idea on paper, but the execution is where it failed. A lot of the levels just felt bland and uninspired. The soundtrack is okay. Really not much. No real right home tracks at all. I mean, there's a couple maybe standout tracks, but nothing really too spectacular and anything that we haven't heard before. So we're going to go ahead and put Sonic Forces in F tier. Just because that game, it could have been so much more. It was riding the Mania hype when they announced it. You know, they were going to, it looked like it was going to be a successor to Sonic Generations. And I mean, technically it kind of is, because there's Sonic, Classic Sonic and Modern Sonic. Just not a good game. Moving on, we got Sonic Adventure, the first in the 3D Sonic games. Very, very fun game. A lot of fun to be had with this game. But it's not without its problems. It is not aged well at all. The original, or really the DX version. If you're going to play one, the DX version is definitely the way to go. But, you know, it was cool. It featured 6 different styles of gameplay. The soundtrack was amazing. Very good songs on here that have, the songs have aged well. Fun levels, you know, you got like Speed Highway, was Twinkle Park, very fun levels that are always fun to go back to. I'm gonna go ahead and put Adventure in, let's do A tier, just because it's a good game. It's a very fun game. I have a lot of good memories with this game, but it's just not perfect. It hasn't aged well, but I mean, it's still fun. It's worth a playthrough. If you've never played it before, it's always worth going back to. So now we got Sonic 06, and you know, what could be said about this game that already hasn't been said? You know, it's a glitchy nightmare. There's really not much to say about this game that already hasn't been said. So I'll go ahead and just keep it simple. I'm gonna put Sonic 06 in F tier, just because, you know, it really deserved to be better. I would give it D tier for the soundtrack alone. Like, there's some really good songs on there, and it really deserved to be better, but it just, man, it fell short. And it is a class A example on what can happen when a studio is rushed and a game is just kind of shoved out for a release and a launch date, and just how to tarnish a reputation of a series. Next we have Sonic Adventure 2, Sonic Adventure 2 Battle 2 as well. I mean, if you want to throw that one in there. This is my personal favorite Sonic game of all time, so I'm going to sound extremely biased on this. This game definitely just kind of blew all my expectations out of the water when it first released. Just the soundtrack is incredible. There are so many good songs. There's not a single bad song on the soundtrack. Shadow is such an awesome character and like a great addition to the story. Just kind of like a darker side of Sonic. So something we've never really seen before. I'm going to go ahead and put this game in S tier. Sonic Mania. Sonic Mania, oh my goodness. I don't think I've ever been as hyped for a Sonic game than I was for Sonic Mania. When that game first got announced, Whew, man, I was not ready. And that this is just the perfect example of a Sonic game done right. Sega definitely making the right calls and letting Christian Whitehead and T-Lopes and everybody over there just heading up the game, pretty much creating it from scratch. Phenomenal game. Definitely gets an S tier. Sonic Heroes, I've got a love-hate relationship with this game. Back when I was younger, I really loved this game. Looking back, it's not really as fun as I remember. The thing that gets me is this soundtrack is so good. The soundtrack is so good. The gameplay, it was very ambitious in the sense of like making it so you play as teams and you know you can switch between them in the middle of the level and having different puzzles that only certain characters can do, like Tails or like Charmy B, Rouge, E102, Gamma, or Beta, whoever, one of the robots. It's one of the robots. So anyways, gonna put it in A tier. Levels are fun. The songs are very memorable. Could have been better. It's not the worst Sonic game. It's definitely a good Sonic game. I would even say it was great. Sonic Unleashed, also very polarizing. If you're looking at it from a half side on the Sonic side, it is phenomenal. Sonic levels are great. Very good examples of what a modern Sonic game can be. The Werehog levels, not necessarily for everybody. This game has one of the worst Sonic levels in the history of the game with Eggman Land. Very, very bad level. Did not enjoy that level at all. But overall, I'm going to have to give this game a B tier. Very good game. Could have been better, but I see what they were going for here. They were trying to change up the formula, and it worked to an extent. Then we got the original Sonic game, the game that started it off. It's a timeless classic, honestly. This game definitely changed the industry forever. But looking back, I mean, everything that could have been improved upon was in later games. So for that reason alone, I'm going to put it in A tier as well. You know, it was very basic. It was the first game. You know, there's really not much else to say. But if you're looking at it from a face value, it's great. Soundtrack is great. Levels are fun. It's a good Sonic game. Sonic 2, my personal favorite classic Sonic game, introduced Tails. Just the total package in classic Sonic games before Sonic 3. So for that reason, I'm going to give it a S tier. I'm going to go ahead and go low S tier here. Sonic 3 kind of improved on everything there. But personally, I would prefer Sonic 2, but I can't, you know, deny the facts. And then we've got Sonic Generations. This game, whoo, man. When I say I wasn't as excited for a Sonic game besides Sonic Mania, this game was a close second. Oh my goodness. I was so excited for this game to release back in the day. And then when it did, I played so much of this game. This is the first Sonic game I actually 100%ed. Just kind of completing all the side missions and everything and getting all the Chaos Emeralds and all that. It was very fun. Couldn't put this game down at all until I just did everything there was to do. Definitely worth the playthrough. Gonna go ahead and put that in A tier just because, you know, it's a good game. The classic Sonic physics are a little bit wonky. You know, they're not as good as, you know, the actual classic Sonic games, but it's really not much else to say. Yeah, that's my Sonic tier list here. Take it for what it is. If you've got any adjustments to make, because I know everybody does, let me know. Please just share your opinions. I'd love to get back with them. Love to read them and share. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know what you think of these kind of videos. I definitely had a great time making it. I really enjoyed it. I definitely plan on doing this for other lists. Let me know if there's anything you guys would want me to make a tier list on, any requests. I love tier lists. I love putting things in categories. So just let me know and I'll make it happen. And thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you enjoy the video and have a great rest of your day.